Yung father namin is a martial artist na for self-defense. Nung time na yon, sumikat yung boxing. Pinush niya kami mag-boxing. Elementary, nag-boxing ako kasi yung older brother ko is instructor ng karate. Yun, nagka-karate rin ako nung elementary. Yung pangarap ko nun is sumikat at saka makatapos sa pag-aaral para makaahon yung pamilya ko sa hirap ng buhay. During my time, pag manalo ka, 50 pesos. Pag may makuha kaming mga cash prize, yun yung ginagamit namin para pangdagdag sa allowance namin sa school. 1990s, naglaro ako ng kickboxing sa isang malayong lugar sa bundok. 42 kilos ako during the time, naglumalaban ako sa malaking laban para makakuha lang ng ekstrang kita para magkaroon ng pambili ng pagkain. Yun, nag-champion ako sa my weight class ko. Yun, nag-stop ako ng box, ng pro. Kasi dahil sa gusto kong makaahon sa paghirap, sabi ko, this opportunity na makapasok ako sa sundalo, magkaroon ako ng stable na salary para makatulong ako sa family. 2001, December, sinabihan ulit ako ng kasama kong boxing na sundalo na maglaro ka ng wushu. Sabi ko, ano yung wushu? National competition. It's my first na naglaro ako sa wushu. Baga, yung athlete na yun, as in, ang lakas sa wrestling, even sa strike. Pero ginamitan ko siya ng laro ng boxing, laro ng taekwondo, at saka karate na style. Kaya nag-champion ako sa unang compete ko sa national games sa wushu. Nung nag-champion ako, 2002, kinuha nila ako maging training pool.
Another big win for Rene Catalan.
Nag-ship lang ako as MMA nung nag-offer na sa akin yung manager ko sa China na it gusto kong maglaro ng one championship. One championship yun eh. Lahat pangarap maglaro sa one championship. Patay buhay ako dati sa boxing skills ko. Walang bukas. Pero ngayon, nagkakaroon ng experience. Kumbaga, on time. Tinuruan ako ng not just for to learn martial arts for self-defense, kundi malaking tinulong niya or epekto sa buhay ko kasi na-carry ko yung tinatawag na discipline, respeto, maging totoong tao. Maka-learn how to reach the goal.
It's over! It's 6 wins in a row for Rene Catalan! This one should be an absolute cracker. We are set for 3 rounds, but will it go that far? A magnificent crowd continues to file in to the massive Mall of Asia Arena in Manila. It's our prelim show of one championship reign of kings. Rahardian in the grey trunks bounds out of his corner. Catalan in the red has the crowd behind him. First Filipino on tonight's show. A tentative start. Both men know each other well. They've studied each other's styles. Followed all the power. And there's a nice jab too from Rahardian. The leaner, ganglier of the two. The shorter, stockier Rene Catalan. The leader of the massive Catalan clan. Plows forward with a double hook.
Some beautiful hooks coming off Catalan. Nice attack to the body there. This is really going to be the difference for Catalan. You know, he's not used to having, opponents that are this, as far as the striking capabilities of Catalan. It's explosive. And this is where Catalan really is going to shine because he usually uses his wrestling as of late, where he's taken his opponents down and just beaten on him. But now he's probably going to want to stay out of the ground area and keep this match on his feet.
One of these two men's magnificent streak will come to an end tonight. Big outside leg kick from Catalan. And the guy for the Wushu champion. And he backs up Lahadian. There's the power of Rene Catalan. And he gets on the inside again. Steffa Lahadian failing to use his reach early on here, Dragon.
He's got to put that jab out there. Look at that. He's closing that distance.
Rene Catalan, house on fire, ties him up, presses him against the cage. Chance for the knees now. Turn around by Lahadian. Overhook on the left arm there by Rene Catalan. What a start for the ferocious Filipino.
And that's a gift for Rahardian. Catalan should not be clinching with Rahardian. He should separate and get back to throwing those hands. Because yeah, he was having a lot of success. This is where Rahardian wants to be. He likes to take down from the clinch. He likes to change levels and start to threaten at least a takedown here, because Catalan was beating him ruthlessly.
Catalan pressing Rahardian against the wire here. As Mitch said, Catalan should get some distance, work those hooks and those leg kicks again.
We've seen the wrestling of Catalan improve so much as of late. And that's got to be thanks to the wrestling coach out there at the Catalan Fighting System. We've got high-level Wushu against some BJJ, but look at that takedown defense to turn it into offense from Catalan. Now he's got a guillotine.
Catalan trying to choke out the hard one here in the first round. Listen to this punch.
Look at that defense from Rahardian. He went underneath the leg and basically just body slammed Catalan into the fence. Catalan's got to let go of this because there's a choke right there. Look at his shoulder being pressed up against the jugular of Catalan. There's a Von Flue choke.
This place is only about a quarter full. It's going to be a sellout in about an hour's time, and already it is deafening for Rene Catalan. Can you imagine the noise later on for Edward Filayan, for Kevin Ballignon? It's going to be nuts in here, man.
Oh, man. The team Lakai is absolutely low. Nice transition from Catalan to get back up to his feet.
Filipino crowd right behind Rene Catalan. Catalan locking onto the leg of Rahardian. What an opening round for Rene Catalan. Gets a takedown. Rahardian tried to get back to his feet. Rolls through. Sprawl out there from Catalan. Back to his feet. Holy! Rene Catalan having a superb opening round. Still though, pressed up against Rahardian, not creating that space to work those strikes.
Yeah, and I think that's more of just Rahardian keeping tight in the clinch. Look how he's using his overhooks and underhooks just to stay close to Catalan. But Catalan has no fear to go to the ground with the submission specialist.
Let's see if Catalan getting those hooks working again now.
Looking for that leg kick again. That did a lot of damage. It even took the feet out from under Rahardian.
He takes the legs from Rahardian, and it's going to make it very hard for the Indonesian to shoot in and get a takedown. Uppercut there from Catalan, telegraphed it off the lead hand. Rahardian tucking the chin as well he should, looking through the brow. Catalan trying to maintain control of center catch. Thought about the jab too. Final seconds of the opening round. What has been an absolute cracker for the Philippines, Rene Catalan. Where are you watching live on Twitter, live on Facebook, live on the One Super app? It's Rain of Kings, our prelim show from the Mall of Asia Arena in Manila.
Look at these leg kicks. Look how he finishes each combination with a low kick, and he's attacking that lower leg. I like that. Look at this. Rahardian went for the outside trip, and beautifully done counter by Catalan to change direction and put Rahardian on his back. Huge round for the Filipino, Rene Catalan.
We are told that there is a massive line snaking its way around the arena outside. It is the hottest ticket in Manila tonight, inside the massive Mall of Asia Arena. For One Championship Reign of Kings, we are expecting a sellout. And it's already deafening in here for Rene Catalan. I can't imagine what it'll be like for Flying Bellignon later on tonight. Also Joshua Pacio.
All right, ready?
Can Catalan get the first win for Team Philippines? Second round set for three. First was a corker. What does Rahardian need to do here, Mitch?
Rahardian, first of all, needs to utilize that jab. Change levels and then look for a double leg. He doesn't want to stand and, you know, have the Rene Catalan looking down on him like this, because he's a Wushu World Champion. He has competed hundreds of times in the stand-up arts. So Rahardian's got to get this match quickly to the ground and not stand at range, especially at kicking range of Catalan.
Stefa Rahardian has never experienced defeat.
But you can't just shoot like that on Catalan, man. You've got to put together some punches first. Make him think you're going to strike and then change levels to go for that double leg.
Looking for the underhook on that left there. Stefa Rahardian, oh, rips the left hand into the liver. Does Rene Catalan. Rahardian puts him against the cage. A real joust in the clinch up here. Catalan, so tremendously strong, like a little ox. He just shrugs off Rahardian. Watch for the leg kicks now. Watch for the hooks off Catalan. There's the hook. Smack bang on the kisser. And Rahardian did a kick count of his teeth. A takedown defense there from Catalan.
A beautiful defensive turn into offense in that takedown from Rahardian. Rahardian's got to be very careful on his feet. The way Catalan is changing levels and coming up with that big hook.
Rene Catalan having the performance of a lifetime so far. What's he looking for here, Dragon?
He tried to turn the corner real quick, but Rahardian was too wise to it. He knew how to settle down the hips. Now he's going to try to pass the guard, but Catalan closes the guard. This is where Rahardian wanted to be.
Rahardian inside the guard of Catalan as we approach the halfway mark of this tremendous bout.
This match is going to say a lot about Rahardian, you know? This is the first time he's really been put and hit with a lot of big shots. You know, we're used to seeing him just dominate opponents and outwork them on the ground. But Catalan is very slick on his own. Look at him striking from the back.
Catalan working off his back. Rahardian looking to pass to the left side of the body. Couldn't get there. Looks to go to side control. Catalan keeps him inside the guard. Nice work from the Filipino. Cracks an elbow to the collarbone of the Indonesian. I'm just so impressed by Rene Catalan so far here tonight, Mitch.
Yeah, he was maintaining guard pretty well, but Rahardian stepped over one leg and now he's in half guard. So I'd like to see, you know, Catalan take that left arm and start to get underneath the right arm there. There you go. That's what he's trying to do. Almost got it, but Rahardian knows exactly what Catalan's trying to do, so he's going to keep his arm nice and tight. And as long as Catalan can't get that underhook on that left side, Rahardian's going to be able to flatten him out and just kind of pound on him, but he's got to be active.
Rahardian did predict a second round finish by a rear naked choke. Catalan predicted a finish by a ground and pound. 90 seconds remaining, second round of three. First round was a beauty from Rene Catalan. Locking up the left arm over Rahardian. Catalan posturing up for the ground and pound. Now the Indonesian gets a little bit of posture. Rakes a forearm across the forehead. Looks to pass again. Catalan not letting him go to the side. Looks to pass once more here. And Catalan keeps him in half guard.
Yeah, Catalan's doing a good job of just kind of following Rahardian around. As Rahardian's trying to change directions and trying to pass the guard of Catalan, Catalan's doing a good job just by keeping that leg up. Just as I said that, Rahardian passes into side control. And Catalan's pretty explosive, so he might be able to power his way out of this.
Dominant position now for Rahardian. Can he make good use of it? 30 seconds remains. Elbow to the side of the head there from Catalan. Knee from Rahardian, takes the back. Slips over the top though. What can he look for here, Mitch?
Ah, see, that's the explosion that I was talking about. Right as Rahardian tried to get into mount, Catalan bridged out and very nicely got on top. Rahardian's continuing the pressure. Uh-oh. Nice change of levels there from Rahardian, but Catalan was wise to it.
Beautiful knee there from Catalan. Rahardian puts him against the wire. Dicks to the body. There's two rounds down, one to go.
Look at this. Beautifully done. Right on the button. Wobbled back Rahardian. I don't think Rahardian's ever been hit that hard. Nice takedown defense there, but he's trying to punch rather than controlling the position. You can see him. Look at this. Beautifully done hip toss into it. Uchimata had the overhook through his leg in between, and a beautiful, again, turning his defense into offense from Catalan.
And it's all part of one championship reign of King's Fun from Manila, the Philippines. It's our prelim show as we tick down towards a triple main event tonight, including the return, the comeback of the legend, Enzo Gracie, Shannon Ruichai versus Shinya Aoki. And Martin Nguyen looks to become the sport's first ever simultaneous three-division champion against Kevin Bellignon for the interim bantamweight strap. Third and final round. Wherever you're watching live, on Facebook Live, on Twitter Live, on the One Super app, I hope you're enjoying all this magnificent martial arts action.
Catalan set up that hook again. That's the weapon that's been landing him over and over again. Rahardian's dropping that right hand a little bit, leaving his chin exposed, and Catalan is wise to it, and he's throwing that big left hook. He's changing levels and then coming up really quickly.
Rahardian just loosening the arms, the long arms. He's got to use them, use the range, use the reach, and keep Catalan at bay.
But when his punching range is essentially Catalan's kicking range. So I'd like to see Catalan start throwing those leg kicks, throwing a little bit of the 1-2, boom, going down low with that leg kick again.
Catalan switching stances, looking cagey here, the veteran. And referee Olivia Costa says, you've got to engage. Catalan edges forward. Left hand cocked and ready to come down the center corridor or to hook. Shakes it off as Catalan resets, goes back to orthodox stance now. There's the outside leg kick, hits that common peroneal nerve just above the knee.
It's a good weapon for him. You can see Rahardian is not checking it. He's not defending it. He's not trying to catch it and go for a takedown. That leg kick is there all day. Catalan should just keep going back to it until Rahardian changes something.
Left hook there from Rahardian. Inside leg kick. Nice little step across there from Catalan. Fake from Catalan. Drifts out of the way. Looking very confident here, Rene Catalan sprawls out, defends the takedown attempt.
See, this distance is perfect for Catalan. He's still inside kicking range, and Rahardian's not setting up that takedown. He's just shooting in at him, and Catalan has proven so far that he can sprawl heavy onto Rahardian and just pop back up.
Leg kick connecting, Catalan fires an uppercut, then a hook both off the lead hand. If one of these two men really puts the foot down, they could go kleptomaniac and steal it. Outside leg into a left hook combination there from Catalan.
I don't know if Rahardian realizes he is halfway through the third and final round of this match, and Catalan might be ahead on the judges' scorecards here.
Big Mike from Bali MMA in the corner of Rahardian, a challenge stepper to shoot in. They want their man to go, they want him to go now. Body shot from Catalan. They tango, back against the cage. Chance for the knees here for Rene Catalan.
Hook landed again, Michael. So he goes, hey, I'd like to see him put together a combination. Go hook, boom, low kick.
Back to center cage, 2 minutes remaining in what has been a gripping affair. Catalan trying to time everything once again, lands the hook. It's been prime weapon for Rene Catalan, and there's another left hook. Smack bang the jaw of Stefan Rahardian. He has outstriked Rahardian the entire contest. Overhand right to a left hook. The Hardian's got to start producing now, Mitch. Time is running out for the Indonesian.
Yeah, he's got about 90 seconds to change the tide of this match, and he might only be able to do it with a submission here, because Catalan is picking him apart on the feet.
Catalan has done everything right. Left hook to an outside thigh kick. Beautiful combination work from the Filipino.
So you can't back up like this. You can see immediately, as soon as Catalan starts to even faint, forward, like he's gonna come forward, Rahardian backs up with his chin up in the air. This is gonna be either a valuable lesson for him, or a huge surprise that's gonna diminish his confidence.
I tell you what, Mitch, if Catalan gets the win here tonight, it would be considered a major upset by many pundits. And it would bring the house down here in Manila.
I like how Catalan's switching to southpaw so that he can set up maybe a big right hand, because that left hand, or a big left hand rather, because that left hand has been landing all night.
Look to shoot in for a double leg, and again, Catalan saw it coming up, tracks away to that lead by. Left hook outside leg, bread and butter combination for Rene Catalan. Now they tango against the cage. 20 seconds to go. Let's see what Rahardian has left in his bag of tricks. Left hook backs him off. It's been another solid round for Rene Catalan. The left hooks, the outside leg kicks. The Filipinos here inside the Ball of Asia Arena believe their man has done it. He pops a fist in the air, just Rene Catalan, as he just pulled off an upset, as he just stopped one of the best streaks in one championship.
Wow, what a performance by Rene Catalan. Look at this. Just waits his time. That was a very effective low kick from Rahardian. I would have liked to see him using that much earlier. But again, as soon as Rene starts to move back, you can see just the uncomfortableness of the pressure and how Rahardian is responding to it by his chin popping up in the air like that. And again, he's landed with that left hand all night. Great performance by Rene Catalan.
Are we going to have the first win for Team Philippines here tonight? Let's go to Dominic Lau and find out.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the Red Corner.
For Rene Catalan. Five wins in a row now for Catalan. And he stops Rahardian's streak.